Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Find the maximum of f of x equals x to the power of 3 minus 3x on the set of x to the power of 4 plus 36 less than or equal to 13 times x squared. The question is to find the maximum value of f of x on this set. That means we need to solve this inequality to find this set first. How to solve this inequality? Move everything to the left-hand side. Factoring the left-hand side, we have x squared minus 9 times x squared minus 4 less than or equal to 0. Continue to factor the left-hand side. We have rearrange the left-hand side. Now we can see from the left-hand side, we have 4 zeros for the left-hand side. X equals negative 3, x equals negative 2, x equals positive 2, x equals positive 3. The general idea to solve this kind of inequality is to use all zeros to cut the whole x-axis into subintervals. For example, here we use 4 zeros to cut x-axis into 5 subintervals, negative infinity to negative 3, negative 3 to negative 2, negative 2 to positive 2, positive 2 to positive 3, positive 3 to positive infinity. The next question is how to check in which interval the left-hand side is less than or equal to 0. The general result is the left-hand side in each subinterval keeps the same sign. For example, if in one subinterval it's negative, in the whole subinterval it's negative. Therefore, we only need to pick a test value in each subinterval. Plug in the left-hand side to test if the left-hand side is negative or equal to 0. The final solution for this inequality is x belongs to this interval from negative 3 to negative 2. And from positive 2 to positive 3. Now you can see why. For example, you only need to pick a value here in this interval to check the left-hand side if it is less than or equal to 0. For example, we can pick x equals negative 2.5. Plug in here. This part is positive. Plug here, this is negative. Plug in here, negative. Negative. Three negatives, the product is negative. Therefore, the left-hand side is negative. Similarly, for this subinterval, from 2 to 3, we can pick a value, x equals 2.7 inside of this interval. Plug here, it's positive. Plug here, it's positive. Plug here, it's positive. Plug here, it's negative. We only have one negative in this product. Therefore, the left-hand side is less than or equal to 0. Now, we have done this part. That means we find the set such that this inequality is true. The next thing is to find the maximum value of f of x on this set and this set. How? This is our f of x. We consider the first order derivative. F prime of f of x equals 3 times x squared minus 1. We only consider x in this interval and this interval. In this interval, you can see that x squared is always bigger than 1. Therefore, the first order derivative of f of x is positive. Similarly here, in this interval, x squared is always bigger than 1. Therefore, f prime is positive. Here is the conclusion. If the derivative is positive, the function f of x is increased in this interval and in this interval. Back to our question. We want to find the maximum of f of x in this interval and in this interval. Because in this interval is increasing. In this interval, function is increasing. Therefore, we only need to compare the two endpoint function values. One is f of negative 2. The other is f of positive 3. We can evaluate f of x at negative 2 and positive 3. How? Just replace x by negative 2, you will get f of negative 2. Replace x by 3, you will get f of 3. The two values are negative 2 and 18. Which one is bigger? 18. Therefore, 18 is the answer of this question. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.